When life gives you waste, don't waste it. Make a biogas plant. This week on Seeds of Gold, we are going to explore the renewable energy source that is biogas. What it is, where to get it from, how to get it, how to use it, and how to use the other products that come from the production of biogas. That's energy on Seeds of Gold. This day takes us to Lanet in Nakuru County. Let's just say, if you have livestock, by the end of this episode, you will want to set up a biogas unit. Hello, Professor Nyanga.
Morning.
How are you? This time, we are all about what you do.
Good.
What is biogas?
Biogas is an inflammable gas which burns at 60% of what a pure gas will do and can be used for cooking, lighting, electricity generation, and all other purposes like any fuel.
The reason why we are here today is to see a biodigester being constructed.
Or
that is under construction.
That is true.
Okay, let us start.
Welcome to Mr. Kinuthia's home.
Thank you very much.
George Kinuthia, who has gone into livestock production, mainly pigs and poultry.
Okay.
One of the things you'll notice is the waste which is generated from housed animals. Mm-hmm. Confined animals do tend to produce more waste which becomes a nuisance within the building.
Okay.
And hence they started to explore the options of how to manage waste and not only manage but recover nutrients and energy from it.
Okay.
One way is the biogas system.
So, Professor, we're saying any kind of waste can be used in the biodigester for biogas production.
Precisely. Uh-huh. Any organic waste can be decomposed. Mm-hmm. The right term is digested in the right environment to give you biogas, which is renewable energy.
Okay.
And I think the major thing we are targeting is if it can burn and boil, it will replace what we are using in terms of firewood.
With the diminishing forest cover, use of firewood is no longer a sustainable source of fuel. Hence the need for alternative renewable and sustainable energy sources. Biogas is environmentally friendly and clean gas. Unlike firewood, it does not have smoke and burns at a lower pressure than the LPG gas. In addition, it takes our organic waste materials and gives it value. Professors, we make our way to the biodigester probably, and I'd want to ask. Now, say I'm an individual at home. I have watched Seeds of Gold and I am curious to have a biodigester.
Yes.
First of all, what do I need to have before I'm even considered or I even consider having a biodigester?
Basically, in this country, you must have animals which are housed ideally, like the pigs. All the cattle, dairy animals, which are partially or at least housed in a day or a half day, and any other source of organic material. Of course, the other requirements, like there should be enough water, and there should be enough topography, sufficient gradient, so that in event of an overflow from the digester, it does not pollute the compound.
Waste generated from a farm, including chicken waste, is reason enough to invest in biogas. The slurry, known as animal waste, is broken down in the process of biogas digestion. This ends up being a very efficient organic fertilizer. So I see the farm also has cows.
Yes, cows are traditionally the source of biogas. They dung from cow dung, traditionally. The reason is because the cow has four components of the stomach. And they are the only animals which tend to produce methane. Methane is the gas which we said is inflammable, is burning, and that is actually the source of biogas. And all systems must be started with some cow dung. Whether you're using pig manure, you're using human waste, you're using potatoes or any like molasses or the byproduct from process, cow dung must be brought in. And okay. The reason cow dung is because in the rumen of the cow, there is the methane, or we call them methanogenetic bacteria. Mm. Those bacteria which convert CH4 or carbon plus hydrogen to produce methane, which is CH4, are only found in cattle. Mm.
At this point, we meet Laban, a biogas engineer. It's important to note that construction of a biogas plant cannot be done by your ordinary mason. You must get a certified biogas technician.
Hello. Yes, good morning.
Salama kabisa.
Hello.
Good yes. morning, Laban.
Morning to you. What we normally do when we want to do a biogas system, we first make a visit to the farmer and we do sizing according to three factors. Mm. You look at the number of animals, the amount, the quantity of waste he is expecting. Mm-hmm. Then we also check on the energy needs, what he intends to use for the biogas. Uh-huh. Then, of course, we also check the financial ability of the farmer.
Okay.
So after all that assessment, we come and site, determine the best position for this system. Mm-hmm. We look at the position of the cow shed. Mm-hmm. Of course, it should not be far away from the source of the waste. Mm-hmm. Then it should not be far away from the end use point, mm-hmm. that is the kitchen or whichever place. Mm-hmm. So I realized that this was the best place so that we get the waste direct from the cow shed.
Cow shed.
Not far.
Yeah.
We feed here.
Yeah.
Then at the end of the day, we shall direct the slurry to the garden.
Okay.
And we tap the gas to the kitchen.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
All right. So, Professor, probably take us through what happens at every stage. What exactly takes place?
When the siting has been fully completed, the land clearing has been done, the first step is the excavation of the pit where the digester would be built.
Okay.
Remember, we call the digester the rumen of the cow.
Yeah.
Where the digestion will take place to give us gas.
Yeah.
So this point, if I go around, maybe be able to see it better.
Remember, before you start your construction, get a qualified biogas engineer.
Before this process starts, a drawing must be done. Okay, there are two levels. Mm-hmm. The plan, which means one point of our structure, another point, and another one. And there's a pipe similar to the one we're seeing. And if, from that side, you'll see the pipe, which Laban said, if you overfeed, you increase the volume inside.
Yes.
The gas, if the gas is stagnant, it will push the slurry out.
The biogas system has three parts. The inlet, through which the organic waste mixed in equal proportions with water gets into the dome. The dome, also known as the biodigester, where breakdown takes place, and the expansion chamber that pushes the undigested waste back into the system and the gas and slurry out of the system. The dome specifically is plastered several times with waterproof cement to avoid cracks, and it should be gas tight at all times to prevent the gas from coming out and oxygen from going in.
How long before you start getting gas? When you put the cow dung for the very first time?
Okay, that is what we call the hydraulic retention period. Mm-hmm. You can finish the loading today. Mm-hmm. After 2 days, you can see gas. Eh? Mm-hmm. But it may not be enough quantity.
Okay. Eh?
So the cow dung has to remain here for 6 days for maximum digestion.
Okay.
Maximum digestion. Okay. But the time period varies slightly depending on the type of feedstock and probably what the animal feeds on. Because the cow waste, the pig waste, they have different retention period.
Okay.
So you find that the cow waste may take a bit longer period to produce the gas, while that of a pig may take only 2 days, and you get a lot of gas.
Okay. Thank you very much, Laban. Asante sana, naona pia mnafanya kazi mzuri sana.
Thank you.
All right, leni hivyo hivyo.
Yes, yes.
All right. Quality is emphasis when it comes to construction of a biodigester. You need the right measurements, you need the right gradients, and also you need the right materials to construct a working biodigester if you're eventually to enjoy the benefits of the biogas. We are yet to actually see one that is operating, but you'll see it if you still keep it here on Seeds of Gold.
It takes a minimum of 6 days to get your biogas working, which is dependent on the type of waste and the size of your plant. More to come after the break. There are different setups for biogas plants. Egerton University serves as a good example of a minimum biogas unit, which they've had for the last 9 years. This should be suitable for institutions like high schools, hospitals, or big companies.
This design is slightly different from what we had from the farmers. Mm-hmm. It has a neck.
Okay.
And an opening which is sealed with clay.
Mm-hmm.
And then there is this pool of water to help us detect whether there is any leakage.
Mm-hmm.
One time, yes.
There.
That means there's a little leakage.
Mm-hmm.
Every now and again, we send our artisans mm-hmm. to come and repair
mm-hmm.
to make sure there is no gas leaking out.
If we try to do some quick calculation here, where you said 1 cubic meter
will charge you about
10,000.
Yes.
So this was one, this is...
124.
124, so that's that was approximately
1.24 million. Yes.
Okay. How long, for example, did it take the university to recover that money?
Basically, for us, in as an institution, we paid back, we saved the money we spent here, 1.2 million, in 11 months.
11 months.
Because remember I told you, we were saving in an average of about 10,000 in a day.
So 10,000 in a day,
yeah,
that's 300,000 in a month.
If you multiply that by how many months? Because of fluctuation of feeding and temperatures,
yes,
it took us 11 months.
11 months.
Yeah.
Is use of human waste also an option?
Absolutely.
Yes.
One, firewood is becoming a scarce resource because we don't have as much forests as we used to do.
Yes.
Schools depend on firewood for cooking for their students.
Yes.
The same with the institutions like universities.
Mm.
So let's look at the option of waste which is generated in these institutions.
Mm.
For farmers and for even this institution, Icharton, we are currently using cow dung
mm-hmm.
because we have animals
yes.
and the animals have a lot of cow dung.
Yes.
But we are extending. The success stories are now in prisons.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Most of the prisons in Kenya have gone to using human waste to produce biogas. It has its own challenges, but there are success stories.
Mm-hmm.
North Kinangop Catholic Hospital has been running a sewer system producing biogas for the last 15 years. But for semi-solid disposal, like in prisons, in schools, which are not fully pit latrines, they are not flushable systems, this will work. And it has worked very well.
Mm. Now, other than biogas, what is the other product that can come from the biodigester?
The waste from the digestion process.
Mm.
The digestion takes place in the digester under anaerobic conditions, comes out as bioslurry.
Yes.
It's also called effluent.
Mm-hmm.
That product is a very good fertilizer. In some cases, it has been termed a bio-fertilizer system, which can go through any plant. You see a plant of bananas, a line of bananas?
So this whole area, you're only using
Bioslurry. There is no chemical fertilizer,
none artificial fertilizer,
last 7 years.
So, advantage of using bioslurry over the other manure?
A number of them. One, it discourages moles. Moles are those burrowing animals underground.
Yes.
Secondly, you do not use chemicals to spray.
Yes.
The vegetables, be it skumawiki, be it cabbages, be it spaghetti, be it any vegetable that you have, including maize, including spinach.
Mm.
We've done experiments here.
Mm-hmm.
we found that it will do better, the crop will grow faster, it will do better, you don't spray with any fertilizer, makes it cheaper. Mm-hmm. And for those who are going for organic products, mm-hmm. then you can produce a produce without heavy metals which are in fertilizer, mm-hmm. in artificial fertilizers. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Right. Now, is that only for bioslurry that comes from cow dung, or can that be any, even the one from human waste?
It is for all organic material. And you see, even human waste is organic.
Yes.
Taking into care our cultural values, mm-hmm. and, you know, inclinations.
Yes.
Including the system I've told you of North Kinang, which has been running for 15 years, mm-hmm. they tend to separate. They have two systems. Mm-hmm. So the one from human waste, because of our social thinking and inclinations, is not put into vegetables. Mm-hmm. It is instead put to pasture, mm-hmm. for animal production, for growing the grass for animals, mm-hmm. for trees.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
That it can be. Mm-hmm. However, elsewhere in China, for example, mm-hmm. they use it. I visited, and the vegetables they eat there, mm-hmm. is grown from, mm-hmm. this. I want to hasten to say that the digestion process is a biochemical process. Mm-hmm. There is total conversion of the original product to what comes out here. What
Very
comes
different.
Out here, completely harmless. Yes. Harmless, because it has gone through that biochemical process, mm-hmm. under these conditions.
Oh, yeah. One last thing, Professor. The bioslurry, other than for use in the farms, mm-hmm. for manure,
yeah.
Where else can it be used? Where
it has been used extensively in fish farming as, mm-hmm. fish food, mm-hmm. pig manure, pig feed, mm-hmm. and there is a possibility of using it as an animal feed. Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course, with bitter additives. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it has a lot of water, so even if you don't want to use it, you can also use it for supplementary irrigation. Mm-hmm. I think this is a technology we can recommend, mm. especially for our institutions. Mm. Nakuru High School, who is a neighbor, they have already gone into it. A number of other schools. Mm. We've recorded in our experiments here an increase of up to 15% more, mm. than when you use artificial fertilizer.
All right. The benefits of biogas cannot be further emphasized, but it has very, very many benefits. We are going to see some of the uses of it when we come back on Seeds of Gold. We have made the 500-meter journey to where the biogas produced on a large scale at Egerton University meets its eventual destination, the Egerton University kitchen. This is where they use the gas for cooking purposes. Hopefully, we are going to have them explain to us the benefits of using the gas since 2007. What have been the benefits, what profits, or rather what savings they make compared to using the normal LPG gas.
Yes,
Prof.
Yes, Karibu.
Karibu. Sana.
Karibu.
Yes, hello.
Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, Karibu.
So what is happening here?
We are checking with Prof the meter readings, our usage of biogas.
Okay. Yeah. So you're the one in charge of
that
section?
Yeah, I'm in charge of this kitchen. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm the one who uses biogas.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this biogas has been in use since 2007?
Yes, please.
And you have records from the first day?
Yeah, we have records from the first day, mm. up to date.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So how what quantities have you used to date?
Up to date, we have used 49,900 meters cubed up to date this morning.
A volume of 49,000?
Yeah.
Almost 50,000?
50,000, yeah. 50,000 meters cubed.
Okay. See, the biogas burns with a blue flame,
yeah.
and the LPG gas burns with something yellowish orange. So that means that a blue flame means it has more heat. Professor,
that is true. That is true. That is true.
It is true.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. What quantity do you use per day, for example?
Per day, we use 25 kilos.
25 kilos,
yeah.
of the LPG or the biogas?
The biogas.
Of the biogas.
For LPG, we use 50 kilos.
50 kilos.
Yeah.
All right.
It is half, almost half.
Yeah, that's almost half. So what we have here is the use of biogas on a large scale. And according to what the professor mentioned, that the size of the biodigester itself is 124
cubic meters.
And from the figures, you said, how much would it cost? The ratio of money to cubic meters, for example, how much would it cost for 1 cubic meter?
For medium This is a medium-scale institution, mm-hmm. I mean plant mm-hmm. or biogas system. It's mm-hmm. not large-scale. Mm-hmm. Large-scale are much huger, much bigger than this.
Okay.
We find them in agrochemicals in Moroni mm-hmm. And Spectre mm-hmm. in Kisumu. Mm-hmm. Those ones are using much more substrate coming in mm-hmm. from the factories. Mm-hmm. However, for institutions mm-hmm. like high or institutions of higher learning, like mm-hmm. a university, mm-hmm. high schools, mm-hmm. we can use, if we have animals, mm-hmm. large constructions, slightly bigger, mm-hmm. 2-10 times bigger than what a farmer uses. Mm-hmm. That's what we have here. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So generally, mm-hmm. for medium size mm-hmm. and small holder mm-hmm. digesters, like mm-hmm. what we've seen earlier, mm-hmm. each cubic meter mm-hmm. will cost you an average of about 10,000, depending okay. on where you are in Kenya.
Okay.
Because it's cost of cement, mm-hmm. cost of sand, mm-hmm. cost of labor,
yeah.
cost of bricks,
yes.
or cost of cut stones
yes.
or blocks. Mm-hmm. So on average, about 10,000. Mm-hmm. So this plant mm-hmm. costed us about 1.2 million mm-hmm. to put up mm-hmm. in 2006. Mm-hmm. And we are happy it has been running since then.
And how many people are fed in this kitchen?
By day, we feed 3,000 students and students.
And staff.
Staff, uh-huh. yeah. We call them customers. 3,000 customers by day.
3,000 customers?
Yeah, 3,000 customers.
From this kitchen?
Yeah, from this kitchen.
What would your advice be to other institutions out there?
I would recommend they use biogas. Mm-hmm. It's clean mm-hmm. and efficient in terms of cooking. Mm-hmm. And also it's economical. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. Probably we can I can have a look at the structure yeah. of the yeah. biogas cooker. Is this biogas lighting this lamp?
It is true. That's a normal pressure lamp, uh-huh. which has been modified, like we mentioned earlier. Mm-hmm. Just open the nipples where the gas is moving through and connect the gas. If you check keenly, this is just the gas we've seen in the car. Mm-hmm. And light it the normal way, a normal mantle, and you have your light from biogas.
So it's, but you just had to modify it a bit?
Yes, just okay. open the jets. Mm-hmm. The air jets up here, mm-hmm. you open them because the pressure under which the air is coming in, mm-hmm. I mean the gas, is a bit low, mm-hmm. so it will work as a normal mm-hmm. pressure lamp. We brought the normal burner, mm-hmm. which is actually biogas with mm-hmm. big holes. Mm-hmm. We want to show that you can package, you can carry the gas
oh,
from a point of production from the digester.
This is not just a bag here, it's
no,
biogas.
This is biogas. We can connect it directly here mm-hmm. and cook with it.
Although still at experimental stages, the future of biogas is packaging, which will offer more convenience and choice for customers.
The beauty about this gas, it is not poisonous.
Yeah.
It cannot explode. Mm-hmm. However, if you are in a big institutional gas digester, mm-hmm. like up there, mm-hmm. it can suffocate. If we allow it to fill this room,
yeah.
it can exclude oxygen. Remember, mm-hmm. we need oxygen.
Yes.
But otherwise, it will not suffocate, it will not kill. Mm-hmm. It's not like the other gases. Mm-hmm.
So far, we have seen biogas installations, a medium-sized biogas unit, and shortly, we will see how you can use it in your home after the break.
Nice home. Okay. From Solai to
Lanet
to
Egerton.
And yeah. now, which is somewhere close to
Egerton
University.
Call it Ngondo Farm.
Yes, Ngondo
yeah.
Farm.
Yeah.
Our biogas journey still continues, but here we are going to meet a farmer who has been using biogas. We'd like to hear his experiences. Professor, let's meet the farmer. Hello.
Karibu, welcome.
Tunapika ugali.
Karibu.
Yonawa ni kama ni mwiko.
Ugali. Ini moto tunadapta.
Yonawa ni kama ni mwiko.
Hapana. Ini moto tunadapta.
Mr. Sol, asante sana kwa kutukaribisha kwa shamba yako.
Karibu.
Asante sana.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey. Now, tell us, for how long have you been using biogas?
We started in June 2013. Uh-huh. Up to now, uh-huh. we are still using.
We found the charcoal was very expensive. Mm-hmm. A bag was going at around 2,000. So one day we used to buy at 1,800. There was a group which was saying about biogas, mm-hmm. The importance, mm-hmm. and how to use it. Mm-hmm. So we approached, mm-hmm. and we decided, we told them to come and install it for us. Mm-hmm. So we bought the material, mm-hmm. after talking to them. Mm-hmm. So they came, mm-hmm. and we started.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. So Mama also probably she can tell us, mm-hmm. what came first, ni ng'ombe zilikuja kwanza ama ni biogas mlikuwa nazo kwanza? Mlianza ndio mkaleta ng'ombe?
Ng'ombe ilikuja kwanza. Uh-huh. Alafu there was a time when I saw Professor Nyanga. Mm-hmm. He was demonstrating something in the university, our university here.
Okay.
So I saw it was good. Mm-hmm. Then I told my husband, I sold my husband the idea. Mm-hmm. And then we decided to have one also, to try to have one. Mm-hmm. We knew that it's expensive, mm-hmm. but we say let's try, mm-hmm. to have it one.
Now, how big is yours?
This one is
12 cubic 12 meters.
12 cubic meters.
Yes.
Meters, just as,
yeah, 12, yeah. cubic meters. Exactly.
Okay. Alafu, iliwa cost pesa ngapi ku construct?
In total, it costed us around 81,000.
Now, what do you use the biogas for?
We use biogas mainly for cooking, mm-hmm. in cooking, mm-hmm. boiling water, mm-hmm. in the morning, mm-hmm. for children to take part.
Mm-hmm. How much, for example, in a month, were you spending on charcoal? Or how many bags of charcoal were you using in a month? Or one bag would take you for how long?
Initially, one bag was costing 1,800, and we used to have two bags per month. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then biogas, the LPG, mm-hmm. we used one,
LPG.
Which was 2,600 LPG.
That, so you'd use it in a month?
In a month.
One in a month.
But
one
it
in a
could
month.
Not finish the whole month, mm-hmm. because of the usage was, mm. so much.
Okay.
Mm, maybe when you boil water.
We were controlling it, mm-hmm. in the morning just for tea only. Mm-hmm. But when we bring in the biogas, mm-hmm. we are using throughout.
For everything.
Mm-hmm. Okay. For everything.
Cooking chapati, mm-hmm. cooking beans.
Yes. Everything.
Boiling water. It is a source of life to us.
Now, so it's 2,000 shillings for a bag of charcoal. And then you used two, so that's 4,000 shillings. And then 2,500 for...
2,600 for LPG.
So that is 6,600 in a month.
In a month.
So you are able to save 6,600 shillings in a month. So 81,000 divided by 6,600, you have approximately 13 months.
1 year.
Well, in one year, you're able to recover the amount of money that you spent on the biodigester.
Exactly.
And that is money that you are no longer going to use again for purposes of buying fuel. That is the LPG and the,
exactly.
and the charcoal.
It can go to something else.
Huh? And this is fuel, the gas, use it for cooking everything.
Everything, every day.
Uh-huh. Another benefit I know of the biodigester and biogas production process is the bioslurry.
Yeah.
You use the bioslurry as well.
Yeah.
That is the best fertilizer, if I can say.
Yes.
Because if you can see these bananas and nappier grass, mm-hmm. fetches somewhere, mm-hmm. there, mm-hmm. in fact, it's doing well, mm-hmm. doing very well.
Uh-huh.
Mm. And so there's big cucumbers, uh-huh. that, mm-hmm. we got it from here.
Cucumbers?
Yeah, very so big one.
Some of the cucumbers from, yeah. this farm.
Just bring one, eh?
Yeah, mm-hmm. We harvested from this small farm, mm-hmm. and there are carrots that these people have already eaten.
Hence they are big. Yeah. But it seems the girl is eating more than the boy. The boy. Hi, yeah, 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 yeah.
Bring another one. Yeah.
Just bring another one. Eh?
Those are cucumbers.
This is not possible under normal circumstances using normal fertilizer. There is a lot of bioslurry that has gone into this. So these are the ones that you've remained with after giving out, selling,
yeah.
out,
giving
after using.
We have been using every day.
Uh-huh.
Mm. Yes.
The farmers who come for our milk, we, mm-hmm. give them as a discount.
After sale service. What would you advise other farmers out there or other people out there in terms of the biogas?
They should go for biogas.
Mm-hmm.
It makes our life so easy.
Mm-hmm.
Because a matter of having somebody at home to take care of your cows,
mm-hmm.
and then everything will be smooth as usual.
Thank you very much. Karibu sana. I would want to live with this. So you're saying I have to buy the milk?
Yeah, wait for the cow to be
milk. You wait for the milk, then we can give it to you.
You pay 50 shilling.
Okay. Okay, I'm sure we can have that conversation further away from the cameras. All right, there you have it. Farmers who are actually experiencing the benefits of biogas. They did not spend a lot of money in construction of it. Yeah, well, it is a lot of money, but compared to how much they saved every month for 1 year, the amount of money they spent was able to come back within the year, and they have infinite use of the biogas for as long as they feed it. But they need to only feed it twice in a week, and they use the gas for the whole week. Gas is awesome on Seeds of Gold.
Even with as few as 3 cows, you can have enough biogas for consumption at household level.
It's that time of the week again for Mifugo ni Mali, a segment brought to you by KCB Foundation. This week, I am in Baringo County, close to Lebus Forest, and we are going to look at milk handling. Mr. Tobias.
We first started when we were still young. My father used to give these indigenous breeds. So we found out he was actually doing good, but not so much. He used to take some milk to the dairies and actually educated us. So after completing my studies, I found out that I should improve the breeds. The milk supply is now, it has now improved. We use warm water when milking. Tunabangusa alafu tunakama. Baada ya kukama tunaweka kwa mtungi ya maziwa. Tunasifu kwanza kwa mtungi ya maziwa, alafu ikisha sifiwa inaenda tunapeleka KCC. Alafu around 60 liters naenda KCC, alafu around 20 napaki nyumbani. Tunatumia kwa manjao na pia kwa matumizi ya nyumbani. Tuko na ng'ombe 8 kwa sasa, 6 ndio tunakama. Kuna improvement kubwa sana. Wakati wa kitambo tulikuwa tunapoteza ng'ombe wengi sana kwa sababu ya ugonjwa. Na pia walikuwa natembea sasa tulikuwa tuna shida ticks. Sasa tulikuwa tuna tibu ng'ombe mara kwa mara, lakini sasa hizi vile tumekuja kwa zero grazing, at least tumepunguza sana. Huwa mara kwa mara wanatutembelea na huwa wanatupatia mawaidha jinsi ya ufugaji bora. Saa zingine tunaamka asubuhi tunaenda dairy kutaka kukamua, hakuna maziwa. Sasa inakuwa shida kubwa tena kwa shamba. Kosa kuna mapato tuko tunaweza peleka kwa KCC ama hata ya kutumia nyumbani, ilikuwa shida. Maziwa tukishapeana KCC, huwa kuna records kwa tunachukua Torongo KCC, nini Farmers Cooperative Society, alafu tunaweza pia kutumia hiyo records ya maziwa kuomba loan kwa SACCO, ambapo hatungekuwa tunaweza kufanya kitambo.
Milk is a delicate product which if poorly handled it can carry microbial organism. I do know we have diseases in livestock which can be transferred from animals to human. We call them zoonotic diseases. So milk handling should be done properly. The essentials of milk production, it means you need to have a clean milking shed. The milkman should also be clean, well dressed in overall gumboots, and should be clean with short nails. The animal also should be a healthy cow, and you should use clean milking equipment, that is a seamless aluminium milking bucket, and the transporting equipment should also be made of aluminium material to avoid the spread of this infection by microorganisms. In the pre-milking procedure, you should assemble all the equipments, and then after that, the cow is restrained in a milking parlor, and the milkman now comes and wash the udder with the warm, lukewarm water, wipe the udder with a towel, clean towel, and then start the milking. After all the milk has been milked completely, the cow is, you apply a milking salve, which will avoid the crack of the teat, and you also dip the teat with a DIT tip, which will prevent mastitis. And then now the milk is sieved before it is transported to the collection center. So most of the farmers use the milking jelly before milking because they believe that the teat are hard. But in actual sense, the milking jelly should not be used. It should come last after milking. It is you either use a remiss or the milking salve. And the milking should be done very fast within a period of 7 to 8 minutes. All the milk will be exhausted.
There you have it. Proper milk handling is not only critical for the hygiene of your milk, but also for the health of the cow and your health as well. Let's keep the conversation going. Hashtag Seeds of Gold TV. Follow us on Twitter at Seeds of Gold TV. Facebook, like our page, Seeds of Gold TV. It's chilly. I need to give myself some warmth. As we live in an age where global warming is a threat to our universe, the use of the renewable energy source that is biogas is key towards reducing the carbon footprint that we leave on our Mother Earth. Biogas has numerous benefits. It's clean energy, it burns faster and hotter, it burns cleaner. And apparently, food cooked with biogas tastes sweeter. That's a theory that we are yet to test and confirm. But biogas can also be used for electricity and very many other household use that we have. Just remember, good food, clean food, biogas. Let's keep the conversation going. Hashtag Seeds of Gold TV on Twitter. Follow us on Facebook, like us on Twitter, or the other way around, at Seeds of Gold TV. And remember, when life gives you waste, don't waste it. Cook sweet food. This is Seeds of Gold.